Hi, my name is Andrew Connor. I'm the pastor of Susanna Wesley United Methodist Church, and I'm so glad to welcome you to our Leader Development Book Club. We are reading through Canoeing the Mountains by Todd Bolsinger and learning about how the mission of Lewis and Clark as they encountered the Rocky Mountains on their journey to explore the continent, what we can learn lessons from them for our journey as church leaders today. Today, we'll be taking a closer look at Chapter 6, Eating Strategy for Breakfast. And I want to invite you to use a tool that will help you engage in this text, to use three symbols, a question mark, which is when you learn something new or answered a question that you may have, a light bulb or a sun, which sheds light, gives a perspective on something that's going on in your community or in your own life, and an arrow, which points a direction towards an action or something different as you move into the future. So I want to just bring a few highlights from this chapter, chapter 6 for me and for our congregation. And the question mark that was something new, or kind of reminded me of something, is what is it that we need? Bolsinger writes this: the most critical attribute a congregation must have to thrive in uncharted territory is a healthy organizational culture. So if you could boil it down to one thing that we need as we're moving into a new season, both in our society and culture, but also as we are beginning to move beyond the pandemic, or at least imagining those days ahead, what do we need to navigate that territory? We need a healthy organizational culture. It's very simple. It's a very simple answer, and yet perhaps a lot of moving parts into how do we get there. And one of the areas that shed light on our congregation for me and from this chapter was this idea of shared values, and it leads on to this healthy organizational culture. Bolsinger writes this: before leaders begin any transformational work, cultivating a healthy environment for aligned, shared values to guide all decisions making must be a priority. Indeed, the values must be truly shared. The values must be truly shared. And this really gave me perspective on our life here at Susanna Wesley. Part of the beauty of who we are as a congregation is that we have a many diverse Christian communities where God's love is in action. And it is an opportunity to live into our expressions of faith in different ways that are particular to an age or a stage or a certain approach to life. However, it can bring challenges when we face values that are competing with one another. And so thinking about this idea of shared values, how do we identify them? How do we name them? And then how do we use those to make decisions? To my knowledge, we don't have a clear stated idea about shared values. I think we have some that many people would share, some that only certain people would share, and others that certainly we would agree that, well, those aren't our values at all. I think some of what our shared values have to do with is a care for children, for generations, multi-generational work, and a tendency towards putting God's love into action. It's not just something we know with our heads, it's how do we live it out in our everyday lives. So I think we've got some work to do is creating, identifying those shared values so that we might be able to make decisions based on them, and together help that be a part of a healthy organizational culture. And so really the arrow, and it leads right into the arrow from this chapter for me, is really identifying what are those shared values. Bolsinger writes these words: before leaders begin any transformational work, cultivating a healthy environment for aligned shared values to guide all decisions. That's what I just said. So you get the idea. I already moved into the next arrow. That is what is helpful. And the idea, really the next step, the idea about taking those into action is beginning to embody them. Here's the next quote from Bolsinger: but whatever success we had in creating a new, more collaborative culture began when the executive staff changed their behaviors and embodied the new culture. Now, he gave an example of working in a church or having a leadership role in a particular congregation where they identified values and shared those, but really they saw the change when they started acting them out, when they started embodying the new values, identifying them, naming them, and not only that, but acting in ways that were aligned with them. And so the opportunity for me, and I think for us as leaders in our organization, is to begin acting out of these shared values. Now, we have work to do to identify them, to name them. Here is the values that are part of who we are at our very core. Here are values that will help us move into the future. And once we identify those, we need to identify them, but more than that, we need to act with those in mind. So I'm looking forward to the days ahead as we make some progress in this area, and I wonder what it is for you from this chapter. Chapter 6 that you found was a question, something new that you learned, an answer to a question that you may have had. What gave you perspective about your life or the life in our congregation? And then finally, what's an arrow that points a direction towards a different action for you as we continue to move into the future as a congregation at Susanna Wesley United Methodist Church? I hope you'll plan to keep reading this book and others as we continue our Leader Development Book Club. I'm so grateful to be on this journey with you, and I hope that you have a great day.